Welcome back, and it's time for a demo. In this demo, you're going to implement a hybrid DNS system between AWS and a simulated on-premises environment belonging to the Animals for Life organization. Now, to allow you to get started with the demo lesson, the first thing you'll need to do is to create the base infrastructure, and you're going to use CloudFormation. That will create the AWS side on the left and the simulated on-premises environment on the right. Once the preparation steps have been completed, step one is that you'll need to verify there's no network or DNS integration between the two environments. And for this step, you'll be attempting to ping and resolve one side from an instance on the other, and then vice versa. Step two is that you're going to be establishing hybrid network connectivity. In the production setting, this might be using a direct connect, but for this demonstration, it will be simulated using a VPC peer. At this stage, the two environments will have network connectivity, but crucially, no DNS integration. Step 3 is where you'll configure the inbound integration, allowing the on-premises environment to resolve any DNS records which are stored within zones within the AWS environment. In this case, the zone is aws.animalsforlife.org. And then lastly, in step 4, you'll configure outbound endpoints and forwarding rules, and these will forward queries for the corp.animalsforlife.org DNS zone to the DNS servers which are in the on-premises environment. And that will allow both sides of this architecture to interact with the other from a DNS perspective. Now, it's a lot to do, but I'll be talking you through it step by step. So let's get started. Now, to get started, you'll need to be logged in to the general AWS account. So that's the management account of the organization. And as always, have the Northern Virginia region selected. Now, attached to this lesson is a one-click deployment link that you can use to deploy the infrastructure that we'll be using. So go ahead and click on that link. That's going to take you to a quick create stack page, and everything should be pre-populated. Just scroll to the bottom, check the acknowledgement box, and then click on create stack. Now, you'll need this stack to be in a create complete state before you continue with the demo lesson. So go ahead and pause the video, wait for this to change into create complete, and then you're good to continue. Now, before you get started, attached to each lesson in this series is a full set of text-based instructions. So I do recommend that you open each of those links as you start each stage of this advanced demo, because that will make it much easier to follow along with all of the different pieces of configuration that I'm doing on the video. So definitely open those as you move through all of the different stages of this demo series. Okay, so this stack is now in a create complete status, which means that we've implemented this infrastructure that's on screen now. So the AWS environment on the left and the simulated on-premises environment on the right. Now what we need to do is to verify there is no networking or DNS connectivity between both of these networks. So to do that, go ahead and click on the services drop-down and move to the EC2 console. Once you're there, click on Running Instances, and you should see a total of 5 EC2 instances. Now let's just expand the name column, and then sort by name. Now you'll note that there are 2 instances which start with A4L AWS, and these are on the left side of the architecture, so the AWS side. You'll also have 3 which start with A4L-on-prem, and these are inside the simulated on-premises environment. Now, what I would recommend at this point is to wait until all of these instances show 2 out of 2 status checks before continuing. We just need to make sure that you don't have any problems connecting to these instances with Session Manager. If you do have any problems connecting with Session Manager, then you just need to wait a few more minutes and then try that step again. So the first step to verify that we don't have any networking or DNS connectivity is to connect in to one of the AWS instances. So let's select AWS-EC2-A, right-click on that one and put Connect. Now, these instances are inside a private-only VPC, but they do have SSM endpoints, and so you can connect to them using Session Manager. So go ahead and click on Session Manager, and then click on Connect. And this will directly connect you in to this EC2 instance inside this AWS VPC. Now, once you're inside this instance, the first thing that I'll want you to do is to go ahead and test DNS connectivity. There's a server inside the simulated on-premises environment, which is called app.corp.animalsforlife.org. So let's go ahead and try and ping that server. So ping space app.corp.animalsforlife.org. So go ahead and type that and press enter, and you should get a response back saying ping app.corp.animalsforlife.org, name or service not known. And that's as it should be, because there's no DNS integration between these two different networks. What we'll also try just to verify is we'll select the application server that we just tried to resolve, scroll down and just copy its private IP address into your clipboard. Now, this IP address will be different for you, but it should start with 192.168.10. So copy that into your clipboard, move back to the EC2 instance, and then type ping and paste in that IP address. And you shouldn't get a ping response because there's no network connectivity between these two environments. So go ahead and close that tab down, and then we'll verify the reverse. So now select the on-prem-app instance, and this is the server that's running inside the simulated Animals for Life on-premises environment on the right of the architecture that we've been using. So right-click on this and put Connect. Again, select Session Manager and hit Connect. Now, both of the EC2 instances running inside the AWS VPC, they're both using a DNS name of web.aws.animalsforlife.org. So let's try to resolve that address. So do a ping space web.aws.animalsforlife.org. So type that in and press enter. And you should get a name or service not known, because again, there's no DNS integration. Move back to the EC2 console and just select the AWS-EC2-A and again, get its private IP address. Now, this should start with 10.16, so make sure you've got the private IP address. Copy that into your clipboard. Move back to the EC2 terminal and type ping space and then paste in that IP address. And again, you won't get a ping response because there's no network connectivity in addition to no DNS integration between these two different environments. So that's good. That's what we expect. Okay, so this is the end of part one of this lesson. It was getting a little bit on the long side, and I wanted to give you the opportunity to take a small break, maybe stretch your legs or make a coffee. Now, part two will continue immediately from this point, so go ahead, complete this video, and when you're ready, I'll look forward to you joining me in part two.